Hi guys, it's Rhonda here from Funky Freaks again. Thanks very much for visiting and watching this video today. What I want to do today is show you, go back to basics actually, show the beginners how to do slip knots. I've got two or three techniques, all based around the same premise, but it's sort of how you're holding the yarn and working with your hook, how that looks in these different techniques. I've put a knot in my yarn, look at this, already to start with. So what I've got today is just a really simple acrylic yarn. I think it's a double knit yarn and a 4mm hook, but it doesn't really matter for the purposes of this video today. It's just for demonstration, that hook. Okay, so shall we get started? Let's move that out of the way. I'm going to place my yarn flat on the table here. I've got the short end facing me, facing this way, and I'm going to bring the long end over the top. Okay, like so. Alright, so the long piece of yarn which is attached to the ball is over the top of that short piece. I'm going to pinch up a little piece of yarn. Now this technique I've photographed and I've put into the step-by-step instructions. Now that link I've got at the bottom of this video, so if you want to have a bit of a look as to, you know, what that looks like step-by-step in photos, go for it, have a look at the link. I've sort of got a front view and a back view with these techniques so you can sort of see what it looks like from both angles. So I would pick up my pinch of yarn here from the ball, lift up this loop and put that through. Oh, let go. There we are. Okay, lay that back flat. There's the pinched piece of yarn that I've got here. Now, as long as I hold on to the short end and the long end back here and gently pull, I'll have my slip knot form. Okay, I'll do that again for you. So this time I'll do it slightly differently. This time the short end is over the top of the long end, like that. Okay, I'm going to pinch up a piece of yarn from the ball, there we are, lift this up and poke it through. There we go. It's probably a better angle to see as well. There I am holding the pinched piece of yarn, and as long as I hold the long tail and the short tail and gently pull, there's the slip knot already formed for you. You can make a mistake with this. It's not major though, for goodness sake. It's not going to break the camel's back. But if you were to, hang on, get that out of the way. If you were to place your long piece over your short piece like that, okay, and then pinch up a piece of yarn and go this way, all you're doing is unraveling that. You're undoing it. You can see that straight away, can't you? So that, you know, I think it's a bit of common sense here. You're not going to go that way because it's not going to form a knot. It's not going to do anything. But if you go around the back like that, it will. You hold on to that, grab your long piece, grab your short piece and pull, and there's your slip knot. Okay. So a version of that is what I tend to use just in my hands. So holding my hands up in the air, I wrap the yarn over like so. I've got lots of space. I use my first finger and my thumb to work through that hole, and I pinch through that piece of yarn. Hold the short and the long tail and I pull. Okay, there we have it. It doesn't matter whether it's the long piece or the short piece, to be honest with you. You know, that's why I like this particular. Now there's the long piece in front of my palm, wrap that over, pull through my fingers, and I'm pulling through the short piece. Okay, there's my slip knot. Or the other way around, I've got the short piece in my palm, I wrap that over, grab my fingers and pinch that through, and I'm pinching through the long piece. Okay, so this is pretty much the same technique that we did on the table, but it's easier in my hand. I feel freer in my hand. And it's quicker as well. So that's two ways. Let's have a look at what that would look like, maybe slower and a bit more determined. So in my right hand, if I've got the short piece of yarn, I would wrap the long piece over the top so it crosses over. I'm going to hold on to that just so it doesn't move. Pinch up a little piece of yarn at the back and thread it through. There we go, you can see that. Thread that through. There it is. There. I can let go even. And as long as I hold on to the long and the short piece of yarn and pull, There's my Slipknot. Okay. Do it in my left hand. There we go. This isn't going to be easy. I feel like a beginner. I'm actually left-handed, but I can't crochet with my left hand. My grandma, she visited Australia 1 year. She's from the UK. Taught me how to knit, but she's right-handed. So I had no choice. I had to learn right-handed knitting. So this is really weird for me. It feels really uncomfortable. A short piece in front. It could be the long piece as well, but short piece in front. I'm going to hold on to that very quickly. Wrap that over. So it crosses over. There we go. I'm going to hold on to that again so it doesn't slip off. Pinch up a piece of yarn from the back, and as long as I turn my fingers around so you can see the back, thread that through like so. There we go, pull that through. There it is. Hold on to that. I can let go of the rest without any problems whatsoever, and as long as I hold on to the long and short piece, pull my hands away from each other, there's my slip knot. Okay, and the same sort of technique with the hook this time if you're wanting to put your slip knot straight onto the hook and get going, okay, for a bit of speed perhaps. In this instance, you do need to make sure that your long piece from the ball wraps over the top of the short piece, okay. Hold on to that little section where it crosses over, and we'll go fishing. Stick your hook into the hole, and you're aiming to pick up this long piece here. So fetch it up with your hook like that. There we are. You can let go at this point, and as long as you're holding the long and the short piece, pull on that, and there is your slip knot. Pull that short piece out the way, pull on the long one, and you're ready to start your crocheting. Okay, we'll do it in the left hand. Here we go. We'll do it in the left hand. Let's see what mess I can create now. Right, so there's your short piece. The long piece crosses over the top. There we go. Gosh, this feels so weird. Crosses over the top. We're going to go fishing. Stick the hook down. And we're going to bring that up. Ah! Bring that. No, come on. Bring it up. There we are. I can let go without any problems. And as long as I'm holding the long and the short piece, and I pull on that gently, there is my slip knot. I'm pulling on the long piece, that working yarn. I'm ready to start. Okay, so that's essentially, it's one way of doing your knot, but in three or four different ways. One flat down, couple in your hand, and one straight onto the hook. Please comment down below. Please let me know maybe which one of those techniques works for you or doesn't. You might have your own. And that's great too. Please share that, because I think, you know, paying things forward is really, really important. There's a lot of skill out there, and I think it's really important that we share it. Please like and share the video. That really helps me. This is part of my business. I don't work. I'm a student and I work from home. So anything you could do to help me out would be really great. And your comments really help as well, because it means I can put together some videos that you appreciate and that you want to see. The links below will also take you to my website. So please have a look at that as well. And look forward to some more videos. I've got some videos coming up on a men's cowl, workman's cowl that I made. And I want to show some stitches there. And I've also got some basic foundation chain and single crochet videos coming up for you as well, so you can take your next step. Thank you very much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you again. Bye.